Only insane people become teachers. These were the last words of a teacher before she jumped off a building, because there were a bunch of devilish students in this class. They put glue all over the chalk. The teacher was about to wash her hands when she got sprayed in the face. When she turned off the valve and wiped her face with a towel, she got ink all over her face. She rushes out of the classroom and catches poop on her hands. No teacher has ever taught this class for more than a week. And then this man came along and changed everything. Have you ever seen a teacher who drinks in class? Zeke didn't have a lesson plan in his bag. He had a beer. He's only a junior high school graduate, and yet he's a teacher at this school. He's even got a bad temper. He yells at the students. He robs students of their breakfast, kicking out a pupil who deliberately blocked the door and gave him the finger. Just a few days ago, he was a criminal. He was just released after serving a year in jail for robbery. He thought he could do whatever he wanted after his release. However, the construction site where his teammates buried the money he robbed is now a stadium. In order to dig up the money, he decided to apply for a job as a school teacher. This student blocked the door and gave him the finger. Since he didn't want to get out of the way, Zeke kicked his way through the obstacle. When the student was smoking, Zeke grabbed the cigarette and put it out in his hand. These two students were arguing in the swimming pool. Zeke went to the rescue and got beaten up, so he used violence as a way to hold the students under the water without being able to breathe until they would say they were sorry. Lisi was very angry because she felt that violence was not the way to educate students. The students are immature at this time and they learn these bad things. But Zeke is a robber who doesn't think about education. He just wants to dig up the money he hid in the school. Lisi thinks the students don't know right from wrong. If they don't have the right guidance, they'll end up in jail. Hearing the word prison struck a chord with Zeke. Since he grew up an orphan, his teachers blamed him for anything bad that happened at school, causing him to give up on himself. Maybe if he'd had the right guidance from his teachers, he'd be a different person now. This teacher's first day of class was a disaster. He sat in a chair, got his butt glued to it, and had to walk with it. The teacher next door asked if your class was learning how to crow. Zeke was so angry, he tried to go home and start the car, only to explode from the cotton in his pillow. Will this teacher give up? He punches the steering wheel and says, "What's the point of this pain?" The next day at work, he arrives at the classroom with his gun, and with a flourish, he goes over the balcony and yells out to the playground that the bell has already rung. But the students give him the finger. Zeke immediately pulled out his gun, aimed it at them, and fired. Two girls were hit by paintballs. The rest of the boys are hit by Zeke's paintballs as they try to escape. It looks like they'll have to go back to class. His lesson was to tell the students to shut up and sit down until the end of class. When Lisi comes to borrow some chalk, she reminds him that your student is crying. The student was crying even louder, and he continued to study the rock drill alone. As he walked around the school, all the students stared at him. "What are you looking at? Haven't you ever seen a handsome man before?" Only Lisi reminds him that you're going to be a sissy. At the moment, Zeke is wearing a bow on his head, Barbie pink lipstick and eyeliner. Zeke is used to the students' pranks. He's even more accustomed to his students' grades. It's obvious that his students have an overall IQ of 6. Even he couldn't accept such stupid students. He decided to take them out of school to study, not to a museum or the countryside, but to his friend's house. His friend's house was full of needles. The garbage was all over the room. Bugs were crawling all over the place. His friend is in rehab and is delirious. He's in so much pain he foams at the mouth. Zeke asks if your dream is to become drug dealers. The students shook their heads. Then they went to the next house. This one is a mess. The oldest daughter is a prostitute. Zeke did this to show the students how people on welfare live. It's more meaningful than going to a museum. Obviously, the students couldn't accept this kind of life. Now they're more determined about what they want to do with their lives. Zeke almost got hit by a car while crossing the street through a red light. But hey, as a disobedient person, called the driver an asshole for running the red light. Zeke's attitude made the kids around a passerby laugh and yell asshole. "I told you, kids really do follow suit." Zeke also told Chandel that you were first in your class in the last model test. You're very smart and you should do better in the future. Since the students are still young, they have a bright future ahead of them. This is perhaps the power of education. When the students rehearsed Shakespeare's play, Zeke adapted the play in such a way that it was so popular and funny that the students won a regional award. At night, they paint the train, and their youth blooms on the cars. It doesn't matter if the police come. As long as they come run, they're safe. If the police can't catch a student, what can they do to him? Lisi and Ziki almost kissed while hiding in the warehouse. The atmosphere between them was so flirty. Unfortunately, what the students were waiting for didn't happen. They're furious. The students hiding in the cold truck had it worse. She almost saw two teachers kissing each other. Now everything was looking up. Ziki has become the most popular teacher in the school. The teacher's favorite place was a strip club. He would often smoke and swear in front of the students. If a student dared to skip class, he'd pull out a gun. But this ridiculous teacher had managed to get the best grades out of the worst class in the school. One day he dug up a bag of money and cried when he should have been happy. Lisi discovers a tunnel in the gym and realizes that Ziki is a robber. Turns out he'd just gotten out of prison to become a teacher. Lisi couldn't morally forgive him for his deception, but she fell in love with Ziki. Ziki was expelled from school for digging the tunnel, but a student took the blame, explaining that he dug the tunnel and that Ziki was the one who found it. They thought that would bring Ziki back to teach them. On the day of the final exams, Ziki's friends sent Lisi a letter. Ziki wrote that he couldn't bear to lose his students, and even more so, Lisi. He left all his money to the school to fix the gym. If Lisi left him alone, would he rob a bank again? She left her exams and went to find Ziki when the principal came in to supervise the exam. The exam room, which he had expected to be noisy, was now incredibly quiet. Thanks to Ziki, the students have realized the importance of learning. On the other hand, Ziki was about to rob a bank. He even put on a hood. But then a couple of students came to the car window. They want Ziki to teach the lower grades. Suddenly, a train passes by with the graffiti he used to draw with his students. This brings Ziki back to reality. He pushes the door open and walks over to the students. This time he doesn't run the red light. The students trust him and hold his hand as he crosses the street. He went to Lisi's house, pretended he was on the run, and handed her a black bag with instructions not to open it. He's going out to hide from the police. Lisi was so scared, she cried and couldn't walk with the bag. When she falls down the stairs, the bag zipper comes open, revealing a gift box, a confession letter, and a dress. Ziki invited her to go to the graduation ceremony tonight. Ziki is such a badass, but first he has to confess to the principal that he didn't go to college and didn't even graduate from high school. But it doesn't matter, because under his tutelage, the class went on to higher education. The principal lets Ziki continue working here. The movie has a happy ending. Of course, this is a German movie from 2013 called FCKU, GOKE. The GOKE in the title is a school. Ziki, underneath his rebellious and open-minded exterior, is a responsible and disciplined person. The movie's light and humorous plot also teaches us a lesson. Ziki's transformation is also very well justified. He starts out as a thief who becomes a teacher just to get the stolen money. Then, he realizes the importance of education as he works with his students. In the end, he transforms himself into a responsible teacher. Each of his changes is justified. He knows all too well what it's like to be reprimanded by a teacher and to give up. Since ancient times, to learn, all men must have teachers who pass on the truth and dispel ignorance. As men are not born wise, who can be free from ignorance?